all the time. At ang pagpakan ng Ginoo. An interesting study on accidental death occurrences shows that 20% of all fatal accidents occur in automobiles. 17% of all accidents happen in the home. 14% of all accidents happen to pedestrians on streets or sidewalks. 16% of all accidents involve traveling by air, rail, or water. 32% of all deaths occur in hospitals. And only 0.001% of all deaths happen in church during worship services. Accordingly, therefore, the safest place for us to be at any given time is not in the home, not in the car, not in a hospital, but in a church. Ay narinyo kalimti ha? Ang pinaka luwas nga lugar nga atong mahimutangan, dili ang hospital, dili ang atong balay, kundili ang simbahan. Amen? Pakpakan na to ang Ginoo. Today, we celebrate the memorial of the dedication of the churches of Saints Peter and Paul in Rome. These are magnificent, beautiful churches. Tingani ang uban ninyo din ha, nakakita naman. To honor the two great apostles of the Lord, these two basilicas were built. What is the relevance of celebrating the dedication of a church? Primarily, I believe it is to remind us of the importance of the church building as a sacred space set apart for personal and collective encounter with God. We know that God is everywhere, yet when people erect a building and dedicate it totally to God's service, God's glory comes to dwell in that building in such a way that the building can now be called the house of God. In the city of Rome, we can see plenty of huge, beautiful churches which are indeed magnificent works of art. But it is quite sad today that there are not many people who come to these churches to pray. Many would come to see these churches as tourists. Daghan sa mga simbahan dito, mura na lang tourist spots. Dili na kaayo, daghan ang manimba. Nakaingon gani ko one time, sus ninduta, ibto ning mga simbahana ug dalhon sa Bohol. Kay dire, sige patag panindot sa ato mga simbahan ug sige patag panghimo og laing mga simbahan. Daghan ang manimba. And we are very fortunate and blessed because of that. We know with God's grace, many of our people still go to church in order to pray. Many of us still feel that churches are places where we can encounter God in a special way. But let us not be too secure. It is also quite alarming that even in our place, there is a growing number of people who have lost that sense of the church as a sacred space. Some have abandoned traditional practices that were meant to remind us that we are in God's presence when we enter the church. you still can easily recall itong mga medyo idara na nato. Sa una, pagmulabay tag simbahan, di ba, muhunong yun ta, ug mubaw sa atong mga ulo. Till now, na may mga tao pag yun nga mudhimo ana, even, konsensya ko sahay kay na ay driver nga, ug muagi na sa simbahan ang sakyanan, ang mulabay na, manguros yun. Yung murag mo ana gamay ba? Ang mga obispo o pari, usahay dili na. Pero that's the thing, no? Even here, malimot na tao sahay. You notice it. Inside the church, there are people talking. Murag di kapugong ba? Sa una, bawal gina siya. Kabalong ita makasabaan tapag mag-istorya sulod sa simbahan. And how do we carry ourselves inside the church? Sa una, disinti mag-isa mo simba, no? Tagsarata makita magpa-sexy. Kay maduklan ta sa pari, o di ta pakalawatan sa pari, no? Pag mag-sexy, no? Pero usay malimot na nga, we are not going to a mall or to a disco place. Magsimba man ta. So, we need to carry ourselves properly and decently. Today's special celebration of the dedication of the Basilica of Saints Peter and Paul invites us to renew our faith in the church as a house of prayer and to cultivate habits and practices that make it easy for God to encounter us whenever we go to a church. Nindot sad kaayo, hinumduman nato kining karaan nga panultihon. If we take care of God's house, God will take care of our own house. So, ang pingan din nato ang balay sa Diyos. In this part of Tagbilaran, we are so fortunate to have this monastery of the Holy Spirit where the canoness nuns of Saint Augustine are found. The monastery is a beautiful and peaceful place to pray. Those of you who regularly come to visit, pray and celebrate the Mass in this monastery have experienced a unique and intimate union with the Lord and the saints. As we praise and thank the Lord for this wonderful blessing, we also congratulate Mother Mary Monica and the CRL sisters on the occasion of the third anniversary of their canonical foundation as an independent monastery. And we pray for the spiritual and physical well-being of all nuns of the canonices regular of the Lateran of St. Augustine all over the world. May the good Lord continue to inspire vocations for the community so that there will always be people who pray for us sincerely and unceasingly. Amen.